Now continuing on here in the in our Naviswork Freedom. Here, let's say we are going to cut some sections. We have the claim, labeling it, and let's cut it as a section from claim one. Let's move it, and here's it. There's my cutting claim. So let's select this move so it will show up. So it's on top. Now, there it is, shows on the upper side. So I want to have it on the right side. So let's position on the right, and let's just have a look here. Here to remove all these unnecessary grid lines, we can go to the view and uncheck the show grid. So that is how to show the grids and grid lines and for this project. So now let's go to review. In review, there's two one to one, which is the measure command. From here, you can use the measure point to point. There is a selection point to multiple point, accumulate angle and height. Let's use point to point. You can select here, and let's say we want to measure from here and the bottom of this pipe. You can select, and it will show you the height from the floor level to the bottom of this pipe. If we want to zoom in and let's say have a better view of the section, we can actually measure again using here the plane and to the bottom of the, let's lock it, can lock it actually on the Y axis, so we can have it clearly set in the Y position. We have to lock it on the Z axis. So once we select it, it will automatically from floor to the bottom of the bottom of the pipe, and it will be vertically measured. So you don't have to worry about missing the floor level and the bottom of the pipe. It will be a straight line from top to bottom. So this is the measure, how to use the measure command. You can lock it on a X axis from this position to another x-axis position, or you can lock it also into y-axis, which is on another position, which is the y-axis. Remember, we have 3D view, so there's an x, y, and z. So that is how you will apply all this lock command. It can be perpendicular or it can be parallel. Now let's clear our selection. Let's go to animation. Animation, unfortunately, in Naviswork Freedom, the enable script tool does not really function. It's one of the offsets or disadvantage of using a Naviswork Freedom. So we have to skip this animation tool or menu. Let's go to view. Here you can set your navigation bar. Just like click it, and you will have your navigation bar shown. If you don't want to see the navigation bar, let's just unhide it. Here, the big view cube, which is this side, if you want to hide it, you can uncheck this view cube and it will be hidden. So let's open, show the view cube, navigation bar, and now the HUD, which is this navigation bar, and HUD. The axis grid location position reference view, which normally we don't use. Show grid is when you apply this, it will show all these grid lines and the position of in relevant to the floor plan grid lines. So let's unshow it. Typically, it's not shown. Here you have the mode above, below, all, and fix. It's typically we don't use this above, below, or something like that. You want to measure, you can also measure from top, x, y. You can lock it using the below and above. So it's like a review tool, but we're not actually using all this. This is relevant to the plane, so you can actually use this and measure something on the, let's say on this plane you want to go to that plane, to this location, you can measure that plane, within that plane. Here you can measure from this plane to this plane. Let's say you want to measure something from this point, it will attach itself to the plane and it will measure from that work plane. So that is the work plane mode, and this is just a view and switch. Nothing much on this. Full screen, just be careful, later you may have a difficulty in turning back to this view. So let's press full screen if you want the full display in your screen. Right click, skip the command first. So now, okay, now I have a problem. So I cannot escape this command. I forgot to escape it, so let's select another command first. So to escape it, once you cannot escape a previous command, just select another tool and you are able to escape from it. Here, restore to original setting for Swift. Let's close it and press back to the original command. Let's click here. I'm trying to get home. Full screen. Fortunately, we can escape the full screen now by right clicking and unchecking the tabs. So now we want to go back to that view. Let's go to manage and let's just go to the same view so we can go back to this original view or location we have started when we are reviewing this model. Let's go back to view and split view. You can add either split horizontal or you can have a split vertical. Again, let's close this one if you want to go to the full field view. And window size, you can actually use view or you can make it smaller or bigger, so we're not going to do that. Background, you can check if you want a black, plain black or whatever color you want in the background. So the rest is quite straightforward. Window selection tree, which one you want to place or appear in your display. Let's go and commands. So you can also say that typically you don't want you want this space to be filled up, so you just have to uncheck this. It's much better you have a full display of your screen so you can clearly review and check the system or coordination on this 3D view model in Naviswork Freedom. So basically that is the tools, and the last one is the output and print. It's quite straightforward, just create a print and select the views or those kind of things. So you can print preview whatever shown, you can close and print setting if you want to have it landscape, print OK, print preview, and then print. So that's it. So that is how to use the Naviswork Freedom tools. Hope you like this tutorial and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.